Hello everyone. Welcome to this video on bold reports. When working with large datasets, such as financial reports, analyzing data without grouping makes understanding the overall trends and performance challenging. Without grouping and totals, large datasets can become overwhelming and difficult to interpret. By grouping, you can categorize the data into meaningful sections. Totals provide quick access to aggregate values such as sales per region, making it easier to break down data by categories and compare results. In this video, I will show you how to add groups and totals in a Tablix data region in the Bold Reports Designer. This technique works for both web and desktop report designers, but I will use the web version for this demo. Let's get started. First, I'll create a new report in the report server, naming it Grouping and Totals Report. Next, I create a data source using the AdventureWorks database in the SQL server. And name it AdventureWorks. Since I already have the database details as a connection string, I use the advanced option to enable it. Next, I use none as the authentication type as the connection string already has the credentials. This button connects to the data source and launches the query designer. I name the dataset production dataset and switch to code mode because I already have an SQL query. I enter the query and click run to see the values retrieved from the database and displayed in the preview area. I click finish to create the dataset. Before adding the table, let me add a header. First, I enable the header area. Add a rectangle that acts as a container for the text. And resize it. I change the background color to enhance the look and feel. To add the header text, I add a text box inside the rectangle and label it Sales by Product. Next, format the text by changing the font, color, size, weight, and vertical alignment. If you see an extra space around the text, you can resize the text box and rectangle to adjust the spacing between the text. Now, the header has been added. Next, I need to add a table to display the product sales details. I add a table. Remove the unnecessary columns. And add order quarter and sales to the data row. Then, add grouping to the table so that the values will be grouped based on the selected field. I choose the table cell and expand details in the row group section. Add a parent group. Select the order year in the group by field and save it. See, the parent group is added. Then, open the group menu in the order year group field. Add a child group. Select the product category in the group by field and save it. See, the child group is added. In the same way, add a child group to the product category group field. Then, assign necessary headers to the table. Next, I add totals to the report to summarize the numeric data, providing a clear and concise way to view aggregate values for groups. To add a total for each product in a category, I right-click the sales field and select Add Total in the context menu. This will add a new row adjacent to the details group. I select the value cell and enter the expression to display the text for the total sales of each product in a category. Next, I need to calculate the total yearly sales of each category in the table. I select the subcategory value cell and select the Add Total to After. Another new row will be added to the product category in the data region. Remove the expression from the cell and set the expression to dynamically label the displayed sales data by specifying the product category. Next, I calculate the grand total of the overall product sales. To add the grand total, I select the product category cell in the data region. Choose the Add Total, and then After. This will add a new row adjacent to the order year group. I remove the expression from the data cell and modify the text to grand total. Then I merge the cells as one. Since the currency must be displayed in the currency format, I select the sales and some sales cells. And change the format to currency with 2 decimal points. Once the values are assigned to the table, I'll apply some basic formatting to enhance its look and feel. I select the header row. And change the font family. Weight. Text alignment. Vertical alignment. Background color. And color. In the same way, I format the row's font family. Text alignment. Vertical alignment. And background color. Next, I'll show you how to view the sales details of each year on a single page by using page breaks. Adding page breaks in Tablix groups will break each group into separate pages based on the break location property. To display the sales details of each year on a single page, select the order year in the grouping panel and open the properties panel. In the page break category, set the break location property to between. To display the group data together, enable the keep together property checkbox for the order year group. Finally, I will show you how to repeat headers on each page. Click the product category value row to enable the grouping panel. By default, the grouping panel will be displayed in default mode. Now, I open the grouping panel in advanced mode to list all groups, including static and dynamic Tablix members in row and column groups. Select the static column displayed in the row group pane. Enable the repeat on new page property checkbox. And set keep with group to after. Now, everything is ready to preview the report. Switch to preview from the top panel. Here, data will be grouped based on the order quarter and the product category, and the total sales is calculated for the products. Click Go to Next to check whether the header row appears on every page. In this video, I have shown you how to add groups and totals in a Tablix data region of an RDL report in the Bold Reports Designer. The link to the blog used in this tutorial is in the description below. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.